as we expand this to now we're over 8 Bitcoin a day, and if Bitcoin's over 100,000, that means you're doing 800,000 in revenue. Well, Bitcoin is higher than that. So now we're doing 900,000 revenue a day. And we were trying to, in that press release, to educate the investors. And I think that's what's really key.
Welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Frank Holmes. He's the executive chairman of Hive Digital Technologies. And Frank, it's great to see you again. How are you?
I'm feeling fantastic, especially since Hive surpassed 16 exahash of its global mining capacity. That means we've basically doubled our hash rate since May, and we're on track to 25 exahash by US Thanksgiving.
Yeah, it really is an incredible milestone, Frank. And obviously that's what we're here to talk about today. Tell me a little bit about how you're able to continually do this. And I guess also a lot of it has to do with your team that you have working overseas right now.
I think it's a sort of Navy SEALs approach to deployment. And that's what you're seeing with Gabriel Lamas, our country president in Paraguay. So that's a real key element. And they huddle several times a day with our CTO, Bill Gray, Luke Rossi, who's our chief operating officer, and Aiden Killick. They're always huddling and zapping gaps and getting machines moved. So that's really a key part. But I think with a big part of that release was also we included in short that Bitcoin economics, mining economics are not a mystery. They are mathematically determined. And with all the data that's out on the blockchain, that's why we keep talking about exahash, because one exahash is close to a half a Bitcoin. So when Bitcoin's trading for $100,000, that would say every exahash is equal to $50,000 gross revenue. So as we expand this to now we're over 8 Bitcoin a day, and if Bitcoin's over 100,000, that means you're doing 800,000 in revenue. Well, Bitcoin is higher than that. So now we're doing 900,000 revenue a day. And we were trying to, in that press release, to educate the investors. And I think that's what's really key.
Yeah. And the other part of this is the low cost energy. I mean, that allows you to be able to do what you're talking about there by being able to utilize the least amount of money you can for power.
And coupled with that, you know, the rapid large-scale deployment of the next generation Bitmain S21s and Hydro miners, that also helps drive down your overall cost structure and efficiency as a miner. But I'm really thrilled about Hive's twin engines as a Bitcoin mining and AI high-performance computing, which makes it the only company scaling data centers in both digital money and the digital intelligence powered entirely by renewable energy.
Yeah, you're getting a little help also. Phase three Venezuela is coming on in September. Tell me about the work and what that'll do when it gets officially signed on in September.
Well, I just think it's all part of that scaling we've been trying to highlight out for investors this year. And last week you interviewed Craig Tavares, the president of Buzz, is also buzzing for HPC and the joint venture with Bell Canada is very significant as we scale HPC for AI in Canada in particular to what we're doing with data centers in Paraguay.
Yeah. And lastly, Frank, when all this is turned on, and you get to that magic number that you're trying to get to by Thanksgiving. Are you satisfied to where you would be at by that point? Or is there plans for potentially down the road further expansion as well?
No, there's absolutely, Steve. There's lots of stay tuned to this television series. It's huge. It's very exciting. And we're mapping out the 25 exahash. We expect to then grow that to even further numbers. And we also see other things developing. One of the other parts of this whole growth cycle is HPC sovereign data centers. The importance of having data centers only in Canada, that in Sweden, they want them only in Sweden, Norway only wants them in Norway. That concept is growing and Hive is positioned for that.
All right, Frank, we'll leave it there. Thanks so much. Good to see you again.
Thank you, my friend.
All right, Frank Holmes, the executive chairman of Hive Digital Technologies.